Hey, what's up guys? Chris again. Woke up pretty early this morning. Today's November 6th, and if you're an Android lover, you know that the Motorola Droid came out today. It's the first Android phone to come out so far that has Android's new firmware 2.0 built into it. It is also one of the first Android phones that is on Verizon's new network. So it's been getting a lot of hype and stuff. You might have seen the ads on TV and the internet and such, and people are just getting kind of excited about the phone. Some people are getting kind of happy, some people are getting sad, some people are getting mad. But that's why I'm doing this review here, because the majority of us Android lovers, we're the ones that have been with Android since the beginning. We have the G1, so that's why I'm making this review, basically. I'm just going to show you guys the Motorola Droid versus the HTC Dream or G1 and let you guys decide, you know, if it's something that you guys should be really excited over, really upset about that you can't get, or if you should be fully content and happy with our wonderful G1s. Let's get to the review then. Alright guys, so here it is, the Droid versus the G1, or just a rough comparison, I guess. It's a lot smaller, definitely a lot thinner than our beasts, but it's a very good beast. So let's just get to it with the Droid. First thing you're gonna notice is the new, awesome, totally remarkable, huge high-def display that the Droid has. It's absolutely gorgeous. You have to see it in person to really, I guess, appreciate it. I'm not going to really go over too many features with Android 2.0, but I mean, it does have the new lock screen and stuff. I kind of covered that in my last video, so I'm just going to kind of just talk about the Droid itself and its hardware and whatnot. So yeah, so it's got the new awesome high-def display. The benefit to having a high-def display is when doing certain things like in apps, like maps or internet, it's gonna show a whole lot more, I guess, surrounding area than you would if you had our little G1. It does have the new map app and stuff, the Droid, which is pretty awesome. It gives you turn-by-turn directions. We tried it earlier on the way home, and it worked pretty awesomely. It's a little electronic lady, like, turn right at 7:11. Definitely came in handy. Cool thing about Droid is it's on Verizon's network, and Verizon's network always has 3G. I don't think I've seen it go below just like 3 bars before. I mean, if I'm in here, I probably have Edge, and I have full Edge. I mean, Henry and his phone, he's got freaking full 3G, and that's just ridiculous. That's a testament to Verizon and their power-ress. Another cool thing about the phone, totally awesome speaker. The speaker is this weird like bronze gold thing in the back, but it's just totally like ripping, man. Like if I turn this thing up full blast, it'll sound crystal clear, and it's totally really, really awesome. I don't know if I can even emphasize that enough. A really awesome speaker compared to our G1 and their crappy little tiny mini wannabe speaker squawk box. Overall, the phone looks pretty sexy. I mean, I must say, looks pretty sexy compared to the G1. Right now I am pushing my own version of Android 2.0 or a Droid. It's not really a Droid ROM, it's more of a theme that's over Cyanogen. But I got the little app display. I have 7 screens, more than the Droid. Droid's only packing 3. So, I don't know, let's get into stuff I don't like about the Droid.
What? You don't like the Droid? There's stuff you don't like about it? It's not the best phone in the universe?
Not quite. And I'm gonna talk about what I don't like. So, I guess a lot of the things that are supposed to be the biggest pros on this phone are actually the biggest cons. Keyboard totally sucks. Just sliding it out is like, it's kind of hard. Maybe it'll loosen up. It'll loosen up once you give it a little more flippy outies. The keyboard itself is just really frustrating. It's just flat. Enter is really small. The spacebar is kind of nice, but it's kind of hard to hit what you're trying to hit, and it's just very frustrating. I've been practicing on it. Not doing so well, especially with my big fingers, but the keys are okay. I kind of wish they were staggered. I really wish they were 5-row and they were spread
spread apart a lot more. That would make me a lot happier because, I mean, look at the current heavyweight with the keyboard. That's just, it absolutely creams a Droid, if you ask me. It's basically like the on-screen keyboard, but it's just the physical version. And since they don't pop out, you can't really get a feel and like hit them accurately. You might as well just use the on-screen keyboard with its auto-correction, and that's what me and my buddy Henry have been doing. It's just, it's actually a lot more accurate that way. So the keyboard is a complete fail in that regard. Again, it's supposed to be the cool thing about the phone is the QWERTY keyboard. It's actually the thing that's holding it back, I guess. The high-def display, it's supposed to be the best thing about this phone. It kind of isn't. Because it's so high-def, it actually is making the CPU chug a lot. If this was just a bigger screen on, say, like, with the regular resolution like that, this would be flying right now. I mean, the CPU as it is still 500. It's 25 more than our 528 G1s. This is packing 528 megahertz. This sucker is packing 550, so slight upgrade, and it's trying to push out a high definition screen, and it's just, I feel like it's kind of chugging because of it. Really should have went for like 700 or, I don't know, 700 or a 1 gigahertz like some of the newer phones that are going to be coming out. So I feel like that was Motorola's way to kind of just cut corners and save a little few bucks here and there and get out the old CPUs, but pretty crappy Motorola. Because the Droid is so bomb and it's so high def screen, there are a lot of problems as far as compatibility issues, I guess, with a lot of the apps that are on the market. The certain widgets don't display right. Okay, say I was trying to put on the awesome flip clock. Let's see what it looks like on a high resolution screen. You think it would be pretty awesome, right? Well, if you know anything about screen resolutions, it's either going to be super tiny, or it's going to be like stretched out and weird looking. So let's see what it looks like. Wah, wah, wah. This is what it should look like. This is what it does look like. So the whole reason behind this is because even though the screen is huger, and I mean hypothetically, you should be able to fit more icons on the screen, it's actually the same amount of icons. So you still have the row up top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I mean, why is that? They're so spaced apart. If you squeeze them out like that, you can fit in easily another row, maybe even another two rows. But because they space them out and make it all weird to kind of like, I guess to make widgets and stuff compatible, like Pandora and like some of the more plainer widgets, you can't fit some other widgets and stuff that actually look really nice, and it's just, again, compatibility issues. Apps also have this problem. There are certain apps that I can't run on the Droid, which is actually really frustrating because developers are either going to have to make apps specifically for the Droid or make versions that'll say, this is for Droid. Yeah, you have a cool Droid phone. You can't get a cool weather widget, and you're probably going to be stuck with a bunch of apps that you can't even use, so is it really worth it? Was it really worth it, Motorola?
So that's my full review on Verizon's new Motorola Droid. If you have a G1, you should be feeling pretty lucky right now. I don't need to feel bad or go cry or anything because you guys have a really great phone. I have it too, and it's still ticking. It's got a lot of life in it. It actually performs a little bit better than even the Motorola Droid does as far as, like, I guess, compatibility with apps, maybe like Open Home and stuff like that. You can root your phone. Can't root the Droid yet. Even if you could root the Droid, still going to be a lot of compatibility issues with certain ROMs and all kinds of stuff. So G1 users, it's still rock, and this is kind of still a really cool phone. Maybe ugly, maybe kind of chubby. That's kind of like my ex-girlfriend. She had a good heart, and that's what really mattered. It's called upgrading, and right now there's no reason to upgrade. So the Droid is going to be hitting T-Mobile. It's going to be called the Shoals. It's going to have a new name by the time it comes out by then. So just wait for like a really cool HTC phone. I'm sure they'll bring out something soon enough. So sit tight, fellas. There's a lot of cool new phones coming out next year. I'm Chris Chavez. Comment, rate, subscribe. Thank you all for watching. And I hope this was informative to you. Leave a comment. Thanks.